Hi again, everyone. Welcome back. Today is day six, and today is grounding. So we're going to do some strong standing. Don't forget, if you haven't already, please like this video, subscribe, and also there should be a bell kicking about down below somewhere. Give that a wee click as well, so you can get up to date notifications of when we next post. I will see you on the mat. Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we are doing some grounding asanas. So to start with, we're just going to get a little bit warm. So start by rolling your shoulders up, back and down, just to get a bit of movement. To start warming gently the body. And as we do this, just start to focus on your breathing. So inhale, rise, exhale to lower. I'm a wee bit cold this morning, so I have a jumper on, as you can see. And just take your hands to your shoulders and just rotate your elbows up and round this time. But this layer may come off as we start to get a little bit warmer. And let's go the opposite way now. So back, up and forward. And one more time. Well done. And just shake it off side to side. Do some nice side stretches here. Just take a wee bend in your knee as you do so. Just loosen everything up. Nice. From here, just lift your knee up. Balance on one leg here and just pull your right knee in a bit. And then just take it over to the side and we stretch, just warm it up and in front of you again. Pull in to the side. Good warm up for your standing leg too. And lower back down. And this time lift your left, pull your left knee in, out to the side, in front, pull up and in. To the side, front, there we go. And then just start to pedal at your feet from here now. And just as you bend the other one, just sink right into your hips here. Just to ease everything off. Hear my toes and ankles cracking. And stretch your arms out in front of you, clasp your hands and push, push, push round in the shoulders, and then take your arms back and clasp them behind you here and just push them out and push your chest up. Nice. Lovely. This is warming me up already. Another couple of side stretches here. Great. And just to get our body moving a wee bit, just come and stand to the top of your mat. Just inhale, raise your arms up, and exhale, fold forward, and just dangle here, just pedal at your legs from here, bend and straighten. Then inhale, head chest up, straighten that back, drop your shoulders back, and stretch out your back. There we go, and fold forward again. And inhale, rise. And exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, rise. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold forward. Nice bend in your knees. Inhale, rise. And exhale, hands to heart center. Do that one more time. Inhale, rise. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold all the way forward. Bend the knees and inhale, rise. Bring your hands back to your heart centre. Well done. Just take a wee moment here, just close your eyes if you like, or take a soft gaze, and just set some intentions for yourself today. Maybe that you're going to push yourself during this practice more than you have yesterday or the day before. Or perhaps you might be feeling a little tired, so you just want to be gentle with yourself today. And try not to focus on what's happened today or what's to come. Just be present on your mat here today. Focus on you this morning or this afternoon, wherever you are in the day. That's great. So just when you're ready, release your hands back down to your sides. And if you're not already, come to the top of your mat. And just shake yourself off. Shake it off. We're going to start with a couple of sun salutations here, just to get the body warming. When you're ready, just inhale and raise your arms up. And as you exhale, fold all the way forward, hands to the ground. Inhale, halfway lift, nice straight back. Exhale, plant your hands to the earth and step back into a high plank. Chaturanga all the way down to the floor. And as you inhale, come up to upward facing dog. Look up to the ceiling, push up so your hands don't sink back into your lower spine. Pull up, chest open. Exhale, push back to downward dog. Take a nice generous bend in knees for our first downward dog and stretch out. Pedal out here for a couple of breaths. When you're ready, find some stillness and inhale, lift your right leg up. Now as you exhale, plant it between your hands and inhale, swing your arms up and rise into a high lunge. Exhale, plant your hands back down to the earth and step your right leg back to a high plank. Exhale and lower, Chaturanga. Inhale, up. And as you exhale, back to down dog. Inhale, raise your left leg. And plant your left foot between your hands. Inhale, rise. Don't fall over. Inhale, rise. And as you exhale, plant hands back into the air. Find some grounding. I think that's what I need to do this morning. This is what we need, some grounding. And place your left foot back into high plank. And then lower Chaturanga. And up. And exhale back to downward dog here. Just hold for a couple of breaths. As you inhale, come up onto your tiptoes. Jump, step, or walk. Back to the top of the mat. Inhale, halfway lift. As you exhale, fold forward. Bend the knees, inhale, and rise. And exhale, knees. Oh, nice and warm now. So come and stand at the top of your mat here. And just send your right leg back as far as you can. Get a nice wide stance. And just turn yourself to come and face sideways on your mat here. Legs nice. Creating a nice triangle with your legs here. So from here, I'm just going to inhale. Raise our arms up to the sides. Keep our arms nice up and strong here. Chest open, shoulders back and down. We're just going to take a tilt to the right hand side here with your hip, just to create a bit of space in the left hip flexor here. And you're just going to send your left arm down to your left ankle and twist your body up and open here to the ceiling, raising your right arm straight up to the sky for triangle pose, Trikonasana. And just gaze up to your hand here and just take a moment to feel the nice stretch up your side body. Engage your thigh muscles here to keep them turned out. It's a great hip opener. And just focus on keeping your feet nice and planted, grounded into the floor. And if you can't reach all the way down to your ankle, to your shin is where you make it, that's fine. As long as you're keeping your chest nice and open here. You don't want to cave in. If you're reaching your ankle and you're caving in, bring it up a bit and open yourself up. Take a nice stretch here. As you inhale, you're going to come back up. Let the arm raise you up, your right arm, and then take it down and raise your left arm up to the sides again. You're going to turn your left foot out in front of you here. And you're going to bend that leg into a lunge. And just take notice of your right foot at the minute and just turn it in slightly a bit more. Your left heel should be in line with your right arch. Raise your arms up, take a nice deep lunge into that front leg there. Shoulders back and down. Keep your torso twisted. Straight in front of you here. Raise your arms. And take your gaze across your hand into Warrior Two. And again, you just want to keep focusing on engaging your thigh muscles here. Another great hip opener. So you should be feeling this all through your thighs here. Just if you should really be engaging them and thinking about turning them out, rotating your thighs. Bring your hands back. Again, keeping your feet nice and grounded into the floor. Stable. We're going to go for a revolved warrior now, okay? So from here, lift your ball of your foot off the ground and turn into a lunge facing the front of the mat. Take your hands into a prayer position here. And as you bend forward, you're going to send your right elbow to the left side of your left knee here and come all the way down into a nice lunge here, and you're twisting your chest up to the ceiling, and you want to try and focus on getting your chest in line with your hands here, okay? So come down, push, keep this back leg nice and straight, focus on pushing the heel back and down away from you, so you're creating a nice length through this back leg. And just twist. Couple of breaths. When you're ready, release your hands and plant them down to the floor here, okay? And then send your left leg back to meet the right into a high plank. And hold for a bit. Engage that core. Push the ground away. Create a nice roundness through your shoulders. Ankles back and down, heels pushed back and down. And as you exhale, you want to drop your knees to the ground. Bend in your elbows and touch your toes and lower your chest and chin to the floor. Keeping your hips up in the sun. Keep your hips up in the sky. And hold here. Eight limb pose. Inhale, rise to cobra. So grounding the tops of your feet, shins and knees into the ground. Pushing up through the palms of your hands here. Keeping your shoulders back and down. And as you exhale, come back to downward dog. As bend and stretch. Hips up to the ceiling. Breaths here. When you're ready, rise up on your toes. Step, jump, walk your way to your hands. Inhale for a halfway lift. Stretch out that back, nice and straight. Exhale, fall forward. Inhale, bend the knees and rise. And exhale, hands to heart center. Great. Now we're going to do that again on the opposite side. I'm going to stand at this side of my mat just so you can see what I'm doing. But from where you are, just stay where you are. And from here, you're going to take your left leg back. As far back as you can get it, create a nice wide stance. Come to face side on it, your mat. Raise your arms out to the sides. So then tilt your left hip. And then send your right arm down to your right ankle here. Left arm up to the ceiling. Opening up the chest. Grounding down into your feet. A nice hold. Engage the muscles in your thighs. As you inhale, come up. Release your hand, right hand out to the side this time. And then turn your right foot out to the front of the mat and turn your left foot in slightly. Bend forward on your right knee to come to warrior two. Take your gaze over your hands. Remember to drop your shoulders down. But feel as if you're sending your shoulder blades back toward each other. Engage your core muscles. Focus on rotating your thighs outwards to open up your hips here. And squeeze. Squeeze everything. As you exhale, bring your hands, or lift your back foot off onto the ball of the foot. Bring your hands to your heart centre here. Lean forward and then take your left elbow to the right hand side of your right knee here. And lean forward and twist up your chest to the ceiling. Send in your left heel back and down. Keep that back left leg straight. Engage. Take a nice lunge. And your left knee. That's great. And just release your hands down to the earth. And from here, step your right leg back. Take your left leg into a high plank. From here, drop the knees. Chest and chin to the floor. Hips up to the sky. Come. Do cobra. Again, remember to push through your the tops of your feet. Don't lift your legs off. No. We're not doing upward dog, cobra. Make sure you're lifting yourself up and out. You don't want to collapse into your lower spine here. Come back to tabletop. Untap the toes and push back to downward dog. Let's be in here. Just hold for a few breaths. Inhale, rise up. And exhale, step, jump or walk. Do your hands. Inhale, come to a halfway lift. And as you exhale, fold forward. Inhale, bend the knees and rise all the way up. And exhale, hands to your heart center. Relax. Now again, from wherever you're standing, could be your right leg probably. And send that back again into the wide stance that we did before. Even maybe take it slightly wider. This time, turn your toes in a little bit, either straight on or in at an angle here. Okay. And you just want to inhale, we'll just roll our shoulders back a little bit, up and back. Inhale, back down. Great. Inhale, raise your arms out to the sides. And as you exhale, we're going to fold forward, releasing your hands down to the floor here. And you're just going to inhale with your head, chest up, nice straight back. And if that means you come onto your fingers, that's fine. If you can still keep your hands flat on the ground and do that, that's great. But just nice straight back here. Head in line with your spine. So you don't want up here or hang down. Just keep everything in line from your spine to your tailbone to your crown. Nice straight line. And as we exhale, fold forward, placing your hands flat on the ground if you can. And just hang, take your head down to the floor if you can. And if you want to deepen this a little bit more, place your hands back to meet in line with the arches of your feet. And just take a nice bend. And you want to think about, without actually doing it, think about bringing your feet in together, but mentally, don't physically do it. Engage those muscles that make you feel as if you're bringing your feet in together as you hold this position. And this will create a really nice stretch in your inner thighs here, in your groin, in the backs of your thighs. Couple of breaths. And then you're going to inhale, head chest up again, up to your fingertips here. Nice straight line with your crown to your tailbone. Bend the knees slightly and then roll up back to a standing position. We'll do that again, but we'll do it slightly differently. So just where you are, if you feel like you need to widen your legs out a wee bit more, do that. Just do what your body tells you. Listen to your body and what it's wanting. If you're too wide, bring them in a little bit. So again, we're going to inhale, raise our arms up to the side. As we exhale, we're going to fold forward from our hips here, and our waist, and grab onto your big toes. And again, we're just going to lift our head and chest up, try and keep our back in a nice straight line, tailbone to crown. Keep that nice and straight here for a second. And as you exhale, with your biceps, pull your upper body further to the ground. Again, squeezing your feet as if you're trying to bring them together, so you're engaging those inner thigh muscles. And use your biceps to pull you further to the floor. Great. Inhale, head chest up. Nice straight spine again. And bend the knees slightly to soften them. Release your fingers from your toes and round up through the spine to come back to standing here. Well done. So from here, just bring your feet back together. Nice standing position here. And just let's pedal out those legs a little bit. Up and down. Well done. You've done great today. Now, just take your feet out about just a little bit wider than hip width apart. And from here, we're just going to bend down as far as we can go into malasana. Now, if you can't keep your feet flat on the floor, it's okay. Lift your heels up off the ground if you want your balance. If you want to put a rolled up blanket or cushions under your heels here for a bit of support if you like. But otherwise, if you can come down and keep your feet flat on the floor while your chest is up and open, so you don't want to be caving in, okay? So we want our chest nice and wide, open, back straight. Bring your hands to heart centre and just rest your elbows on your knees here. And then just, if you can, just sway back and forward a little bit. Go. Bring a bit of stillness. And then when you're ready, just rise back up. Oh, nice little leg burner there. Bring your feet to hip distance apart now. And from here, I'll face this way, sorry. From here, just Take your hands to your waist here, and your hips. And you're just going to inhale and fold forward. And just release your hands down to your toes here. Grasp onto your big toes. And then using your elbows, your biceps, sorry. Bend your elbows, use your biceps, and pull yourself in towards the floor. Try and focus on getting your crown to the floor rather than your crown to your knees. So if you can only go here, that's fine. Try and keep a bit of softness in your knees. If you need them slightly bent, that's also fine. Don't lock them out though. Especially if you've got hyperextension in your knees, try not to lock them out, keep a slight softness. Inhale, head, chest up, plant your hands underneath the bottom of your feet here. Again, nice straight spine from your tailbone to your crown. As you exhale, bend your elbows and lower yourself. Focus on using your biceps to help pull you down. Again, keep a slight softness in your knees. Or if you need to bend them, that's fine. You can have them bent. Great, head chest up. Release your hands, bring them back to your waist. Bend the knees and roll up. Well done. From here, just come down to the floor from here, okay? We're just gonna relax now. If you did take a top off, or if you had any layers on, feel free to put a jumper back on now as we relax in Shavasana. So just when you're ready, come and lie down on your mat. If you want, grab a cushion, a bolster, or something to rest under your knees if it helps take a strain off your lower back. And if you want, grab a blanket as well. Just anything to keep you nice and cozy. And just lie back here and relax and gently close your eyes. Palms facing up to the sky, arms resting out by your sides. Let your legs hang out to either side here. Just tell your body to relax. Relax all your facial muscles, your shoulders, your legs. Maybe just become aware of your breathing. Watch how your belly rises as it inhales. And as you exhale, how it falls. And with each exhale, maybe think about your body just melting further and further into the ground. Body becoming heavier, the weight pulling you down. Just enjoy the stillness. The part of your day where you get to relax and just enjoy quietness. Just when you're ready, start to bring awareness back to your body here. You start to wiggle your toes and your fingers, rotate your ankles and wrists. You're bending your knees, just sway them side to side. Just gentle movements. Stretch your legs and feet down low and raise your arms up above you. A nice stretch. If you are, roll to your right hand side and come to a seated position. Again, you can keep your eyes closed at this moment. Gently open them and take a soft gaze to the floor. Rest your hands over your knees. And just take a couple of big deep breaths in through your nose and exhale out through your mouth. Again. Your hands to your heart center. Just while you're here, give some thanks and gratitude to whoever you want to give it to, whether it be yourself, a loved one. Maybe send some healing light and energy to loved ones at this moment. Current situation that we're all under. You ready? Just bow your head down to your thumb. Bring your thumb to your third eye chakra. Just be present in this moment. Raise the head, just start to give your hands a rub to create some friction and heat and energy. Faster and faster to build up more heat and energy. And when you're ready, place them over your eyes. Maybe send that heat and energy around your body. Maybe to heal any areas that feel a wee bit sore and tight. Have come to day six. Bend your lower back up through your side body. Bring your hands to meet again to your heart center. Start rubbing again. Create some more energy and heat here. And this time, just gently place them over your eyes. Just feel the heat and the vibration. And just when you're ready, slowly begin to open your eyes and release your hands away to reveal a smile. Thank you. Namaste. Enjoy the rest of your day.